The remarkable story that is Pitney Bowes began in 1919 with the meeting of a resourceful inventor, Arthur Pitney, and a hard-charging promoter, Walter Bowes. These two very different men started something rare in the history of business. Together, they combined creativity with business sense and created a company that lives to celebrate its 100th birthday. Pitney envisioned a better way, a machine that would automate the process faster, more securely, and ultimately, less expensively. In 1902, the United States government granted Pitney a patent for his invention, a machine that could directly affix a stamp to a letter. Known as the Model M, Pitney's creation was an idea 18 years ahead of its time, but ultimately, it marked the beginning of an industry. Enter Walter Bowes, a savvy businessman and talented promoter with an outgoing personality. As owner of the Universal Stamping Machine Company, a provider of stamp-canceling machines and permit-mailing equipment, Bowes enjoyed a successful and growing business, but recognized that affixing postage stamps could be automated, and more importantly, it could be a huge business. In the spring of 1919, at the urging of a colleague at the United States Postal Service, Arthur Pitney and Walter Bowes met in Stamford, Connecticut. They combined their strengths as inventor and promoter and established the Pitney Bowes Meter Company on April 23rd, 1920. The new company was an instant success. Within a year, more than 400 machines had been sold. What is it they say? The rest is history. Four years after its founding, Arthur Pitney resigned from the company that he helped to create and build. Pitney's retirement led to the promotion of Walter Wheeler, a 27-year-old Harvard graduate and the stepson of Walter Bowes. In 1938, Wheeler was named president and director, a position he held for three decades. A prolific writer and respected leader with the ability to personally connect with employees from every walk of life, Wheeler effortlessly articulated the company's core beliefs, focusing on equality, fairness, and inclusion. In just one of the countless examples, in 1942, Wheeler boycotted a hotel when it refused to register an African-American Pitney Bowes salesman. Founded on innovation and powering commerce from day one, the company has sought to do the right thing, the right way, for clients, employees, and the world beyond. Today, people of color comprise 50% of Pitney Bowes' U.S. workforce and 18% of the senior management team. And women make up 43% of the overall employee population. 31% are in senior management positions. Half of the board of directors at Pitney Bowes are women.
As we begin the next 100 years, start with remembering who we are and what's made us so special and why we've gotten here in the first place. We need to continue to have that grit and that determination to earn it every day in the marketplace.
It's no surprise then that in 1950, Fortune magazine wrote, "Pitney Bowes has decided that businessmen want to do the right thing for their workers just because it is right." This moral commitment didn't end with Walter Wheeler, but has lived on in Pitney Bowes and its subsequent leaders, and it continues today. In December 2017, CEO Mark Lautenbach used the repatriated dollars from the tax reform legislation to raise wages to the majority of Pitney Bowes' U.S. hourly employees. Pitney Bowes decided to invest in its people and its clients to strengthen the business for the long term. Pitney Bowes has a long and storied history of giving back to the communities where its people live and work. In 1953, the company established a scholarship program for children of employees to help ease the burden of the cost of a college education. Dedication to Education, the company's signature global volunteer program, grows stronger every year, spanning the globe with more than 100 team projects yearly. Throughout the history of Pitney Bowes, innovation has been a constant. Innovation in solutions and business models. Innovation helped guide the company into new markets and new processes. One of the early introductions was a multi-denomination postage meter, allowing users to apply different classes for both letters and packages. In 1949, the company launched a mass-market desktop mail station, giving small businesses affordable access to Pitney Bowes technology. Previous models were often too large and expensive. In 1951, Robert Pitney, Arthur Pitney's son, received a patent to refill the meter via the telephone. Because of regulatory obstacles, though, the service wasn't introduced until close to 30 years later, proving once again there's no time limit on innovative ideas. The ability to transfer funds electronically was a major step forward technologically, and it offered a new business model for the company. In the early 2000s, the company moved to digital transfer of postage through its IntelliLink offering. The company found ways to help its clients purchase postage with a mail now and pay later service. The Pitney Bowes Bank paved the way to fund postage back then. Today, the bank supports the funding of Pitney Bowes equipment, postage, and capital assets through Wheeler Financial. These days, postage devices, or sending machines, offer more than a stamp replacement and serve as a hub of commerce for businesses who need to ship, shop for the best rates, and power commerce. Recently, the company introduced the new SendPro mail station, designed to simplify mailing and save more time and money. For Pitney Bowes, delivering long-term value requires leadership that takes bold actions and a broader view than just short-term financials. It's called leadership for the long term, a confirmation of commitment to clients, bringing innovative products to the market, building an inclusive culture, and supporting communities. These values have sustained Pitney Bowes for the first 100 years and will be foundational in its second century. In 2012, the Pitney Bowes e-commerce business had one client, zero physical operations, and generated $12 million in revenue. Today, Pitney Bowes has 629 retail and marketplace clients and generates over $1 billion in annual revenue. In 2015, Pitney Bowes launched a new brand image and logo expressing how the company delivers accuracy and precision to its clients worldwide. Another watershed moment came in 2016 when the company launched the Pitney Bowes Commerce Cloud. An impressive engineering and design accomplishment, the innovative Commerce Cloud would serve as the backbone for new offerings and new ways to serve clients for years to come. Today, the Pitney Bowes vision is to leverage core mailing and related financial services capabilities to provide shipping and strategic capital to help its clients grow their businesses. More than 1 million clients. Thousands of innovations. One enduring commitment. That's the inspiring story of Pitney Bowes as it enters its second century of global leadership. The success of Pitney Bowes is built upon a single-minded commitment that has guided the company since its very founding. The commitment to do the right thing, the right way. A commitment renewed every day to clients, employees, to shareholders, and the communities where team members live and work.